In this video, we're quickly covering the meaning and pronunciation and proper use of the phrase QED in mathematical proofs. So when I'm wearing my physics hat, I see QED and I think to myself, quantum electrodynamics. But when I'm wearing my math hat, I'm going to end a formal mathematical proof by writing this down, QED at the conclusion of a formal logical argument. Now, this abbreviation comes from the Latin phrase quod erat demonstrandum. That's a reasonable English pronunciation of it. And that translates to that which was to be demonstrated. In other words, we're signaling to the reader that this is the conclusion of the formal logical argument. Now, what I'd like to do is illustrate the proper use of QED with an accessible little theorem from number theory. So here's our theorem. The product of two odd integers is odd. And now we need to try to prove this thing. So we're going to start by letting m and n be odd integers. Now it's considered just common knowledge as a starting point to understand that even numbers can be written as 2 times some integer because they're divisible by 2, and odd integers can be written as even integers plus 1. So this means our odd integer m is expressible as 2 times s plus 1, where s is some other integer. And we do a similar thing for n. N is going to be expressible as 2 times some integer plus 1. In other words, just one more than some arbitrary even number. To be extra thorough, we're going to indicate that s and t are integers. So where s and t belong to the set of integers, which we can abbreviate as a blackboard bold Z. Now we can say that this implies the product m times n of these two original odd numbers. That can be written as 2 times s plus 1 multiplied by the quantity 2 times t plus 1. And then we distribute and we get a 4st plus 2s plus 2t plus 1. Okay, now we notice that the first three terms are all divisible by 2. So we're going to factor a 2 out of that. So we have 2 times the quantity 2st plus s plus t plus 1. But then we realize 2st plus s plus t is just some other integer. So I'm going to go ahead and call that k. And again, we'll indicate that k belongs to the set of integers. And that's really the end of the proof. But just to offer a little more explanation to the reader, we'll just reiterate this prior knowledge that odd integers are expressible as 2 times a number plus 1. So we say mn is odd. Okay, so we've completed this logical proof. And we're going to write QED at the end, signaling to the reader that we've completed the argument and we've demonstrated what we set out to demonstrate. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab. And best of luck on your math and physics journey.